Welcome to Ladies of Another View on Beck. It is a beautiful spring day.
It's so nice out there. Oh, but you have to have a coat in the morning and then you sweat in the afternoon.
Absolutely. So I'm Mary and we are joined today with Jan. And we have our person that has been missing forever and we're so glad to have her back. Andrea is back from Florida. She has her winter home in Florida. And it's so exciting to have you back. And thanks for bringing the great weather with you.
That was the plan all along.
Oh, awesome. Yay.
Awesome. Well, we're going to jump right into things. I just found a brand new person to follow. I did find it on Facebook, but have verified everything. And he has some very interesting videos, what's going on down in McAllen, Texas, actually. And some of the crisis, although some people don't call it a crisis, but it is a crisis going on at our southern border. Take a peek at this.
Tuesday, April 6th, we're here in McAllen, Texas. As you can see, it's continuing. We were here last week, okay? It's not stopping. Here come the kids with the migrants from all over Central America, Honduras, Guatemala, you name it, right? Now keep in mind, once they go into this facility, the Border Patrol completely washes their hands of them. If they test negative, they're marched right down the street to the Catholic Charity. From there, they're given clothes, food, financial assistance. The debit cards that they have over $1,200 per person on them. They're then taken to the McAllen Airport in unmarked vans, and then they're released into the United States to a destination city of their choice. Here we go again, folks. The buses come every 15 to 20 minutes. We were down here last week. They run every day, all day. And you see the numbers that are coming off these buses. Look at this line inside this tent. This is an invasion of the United States of America supported by President Joe Biden. It's not stopping, folks. We were just here last Tuesday, Wednesday. It's not stopping. We're here again a week later, and they're continuing to roll. They're expanding every camp.
These folks from Guatemala, you see.
From all over Central America, and it won't stop. It's just not stopping. And again, these people are not DNA tested to make sure that the children with them are theirs. We know 10 to 14% on average do not belong to the people they're traveling
with. And the FBI is not making people do background checks that work at the facilities or where they're going. So it's important to ID these people so they can be protected.
They're traveling without passports, they're traveling without driver's license, and the U.S. government has been ordered to allow these people to fly to a destination city of their choice. Now, here's the other thing. Very few of these people are actually given a hearing date. There is no hearing date. So once they get to the destination city of their choice, they're free to go. They're free to go, and the government will never find them again unless they want to be found. That is what's happening right now in the United States of America on our southern border.
So that's Tim Enloe, and very interesting, and I'm surprised that the videos are still available, that they're still up, but I did find them last night. Actually, one of our viewers had told me about it, and I'm so glad. And if you guys ever see anything like that, let us know, because we will get interesting stuff on, because we just want to have the full facts. But isn't that interesting?
Well, how can you not call it a crisis? That's a lipstick on a pig thing. I mean, you can't dress it up and make it any better than it's what reality is. I mean, for those poor children, even if it's 10% of them that are, you know, unvetted, they are not the children of the people that they are traveling with, what kind of terror are they going through?
Right. And they say it's up to 14% of them that they know of are not with their families or parents. They're brought in by other people, and that's what's so interesting.
So are the
sad?
Are the parents trying to get the kids in so that they can come here, or are coyotes trying to get the kids with parents that shouldn't be here?
Or did they kidnap the kids so they had a kid to take with them across the border
exactly.
So then they can get in with their free ticket?
Okay, so there's so many unknowns, so take a look at this next video. It's by the same gentleman, Tim Enloe.
So as you can see, this is our same van driver from a few days ago, and she is the one who transports the illegals from the Catholic Charity in downtown McAllen and brings them to the airport, and she then facilitates them getting on the planes, okay? So if you look right there, and I want you to notice something, okay? Look at her leg right there.
Disculpe, son de algún periódico usted?
No, 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 no,
Okay. And she brings van load after van load of illegal aliens to the McAllen Airport to sit there and be processed and assisted in getting on flights to the interior of the United States. Now, none of these people have a driver's license or a United States passport or a passport of any kind. They have just shown up on the border. And Border Patrol is releasing them for one reason and one reason only, because they are traveling with kids. That's what's going on right now. This is van load after van load after van load, several thousand a day coming through the McAllen International Airport here in Texas. Okay? This lady here in the white shirt, she's one of our translators, and she is talking to the people about their travels, and we're going to have her tell us later on what they told her. But she's asking them questions such as where they're coming from, what their destination city in the United States is, and whether they've been given financial assistance, who is picking them up on the other end. And again, we're not trying to dehumanize these folks. What we're trying to show is the scale of this illegal smuggling operation that the Biden administration is involved in.
So I wanted to point out in the one segment or the one section where the he was speaking very quietly, you might not have heard what he said, but those tattoos that are on her legs, she had one on each leg and one on each arm. Those are tattoos of the drug cartel to identify them. And so, you know, there's just so many unknowns. And they say that they bring these people in, they drop them off, and they screen them. If you test positive, you go into one tent. If you test negative, they send you up to the Catholic charity, which, you know, I think they're going to try to blame it on Catholics now that they're, you know, the Catholics are letting them in. What they're doing is they're giving them clothing and food, et cetera, because that's what they're designed to do. I mean, the Catholic charities actually are the biggest giving social network in the world. They give more millions and millions of dollars. So I don't want this to be a Catholic thing, but these people, even if you test positive for COVID, they're sitting on the same bus coming into the same area, but one group goes this way, one group goes that way. Now, if you or I had COVID or tested positive, we're quarantined for 14 days, but none of that applies to this.
It's crazy. You know, he kept repeating that it was the Catholic charity down the street, but we did the same thing here in North Dakota. We said Lutheran Social Services was the bad guy. And that doesn't make all Lutherans bad any more than this would make all Catholics bad. And both churches are, like you said, are very giving, and they're trying to do the right thing by these people, because if they are being brought here, no matter how or why, they still need help. They're still in a new country all by themselves.
And like you said, they don't want to dehumanize them.
Yep. This is exactly why, if you look yesterday, there's a lawsuit filed by Texas and Louisiana. Now there's several other states joining too because of these illegals that are being brought in via these channels that they should not be, and then they're being pushed into the communities where there's not really any screening, there's not really anything that's done. We could talk for a long time about this.
Right. We're going to have to scoot along and take a quick break. Coming up next, we're going to have Oley Larsen. He just got off the floor of the House, I believe, Senate. And right back after these messages on Ladies of Another View on Beck.
Respect, innovation, trust, and excellence. These core values can be seen in every building built by Straightway Construction. In the community for over 15 years, Straightway Construction has become the premier construction company for commercial projects. From dirt to design and framing to finish, Straightway Construction is your number one choice. You won't have to look far to find a project that has that Straightway touch. Call them today or go online to straightwayconstruction.com and let them make your vision a reality.
Hi, I'm Dennis Haugen, along with my sons Andy and Mike, and we're showing our support for wind energy in North Dakota.
Wind energy has provided farmers like us with a steady stream of income that's not tied to the weather, like crops and cattle are.
Another bonus is that wind farm owners are required to maintain the roads leading up to the turbines. Because of that, oftentimes, these roads are the best in the county.
Wind energy is good for landowners, it's good for the land, it's good for our economy, and it's good for North Dakota.
Hop in the rig and go down the road with me. We'll cover local and national stories that impact you.
What happens with national debt? Does anybody even care anymore?
Do you think Governor Burgum truly understands the legislative process?
You know, I think he's got a better understanding now than he did 2 years ago.
Why in the world are we having a conversation about being anti-vaccination?
Down the road with Joel Heitkamp weekdays at 5:30 Central on Beck News and online at beck.news.
40 years ago, Aero Service Team started with one truck and lots of hard work.
Times may have changed, but the hard work that we put in to get your lives back in order after fire, water, and disaster hasn't.
Over the years, we've seen so many families lose their belongings due to water and fire damage. Restoring homes back to the original state has made every hour of hard work well worth it.
Thank you for trusting our family with yours.
When disaster strikes, you only have to make one call. Aero Service Team does it all.
Pub 21, your one stop for fun, drinks, and food. Our spacious facility provides COVID-safe fun for you and all your friends. With nightly bingo and specials, you can be sure there's something to do for everyone. If you're staying in for the night, we've got you covered just across the way with Pub 21 Liquor. We have a wide variety of options, from wine to whiskey and everything in between. Stop in today at 1014 South 12th Street in Bismarck to see what all the buzz is about. You won't be disappointed.
Welcome back to Ladies of Another View on Beck. We have been joined by Oley Larsen, and you are from District 3 in Minot?
Yeah, right? I'm a Minot guy, so District 3, and that's the eastern part of Minot over to Surrey, almost to Sawyer, and then south of the airport. So we're kind of squared up. We were redistricted last time, and it did that, and we don't know what's going to happen now when we're in that round again. So
I know, kind of. Yeah, we're going through it too in Mandan. But now I've met you a couple different sessions ago, and you had a much different hairstyle.
Yeah, so my son and I had a bad bet, and I said, if you graduate, your medical, he's going to be a doctor. When you graduate, whoever cuts their hair last or first wins the bet. So all session, last session, I started growing my hair out, and it was getting quite long. And I had not had my hair cut in high school. I had long hair, too. So, but anyway, his college ended, or some financial things happened where he was at. So it was a private school, and it went, and I said, that was my perfect out. I cut my hair. I'm done.
Awesome.
Yeah, so it was kind of an interesting little bet there.
Yeah.
So he's still in the program. He's got a different college and stuff. So
Perfect. Well, I know you've been really busy this session up on the Hill. Working hard, doing a lot of great things for North Dakotans. Yesterday, we had a fantastic bill pass the Senate about face masks. Why don't you tell our viewers about that?
We had a great bill that it really wasn't about face masks. It was about the encroachment of government on people's individual liberties. And so with the help of Defend North Dakota and all kinds of groups. I mean, it was not just me. It was not just Representative Holverson or Representative Magrum, who are the co-sponsors and sponsors of the bill. It was a very humbling event of the help that people came forward and did. Filled the Capitol. First time in my session that the Capitol balcony in the Senate was very vocal and very in a good way, and they were reaching out to their senators who and just the grassroots of people being engaged. And I don't think that the problem would have ever happened if there wouldn't have been a separation from the CDC and OSHA. So there's truth out there, but from 2019 after, something happened and they separated, because OSHA is the driver of why we can have so many people in a room, why we wear face masks, why we wear respirators, why, and their policies, why they do things, is what happened to that bill. There was a disconnect. And so the governor definitely overreached his authority, and I'll say that every time somebody asks me, and I hear that people say, well, the governor did the best he could, and I wouldn't want his spot in a minute. I would do his spot, and I absolutely would not have done it the way he did it. Amen. There's no way I would have taken people's rights. I wouldn't have shut down establishments, cutting hair, all of that. I call it a scamdemic. I believe the virus has killed people. I know it has. That is a truth. But the way we're handling it and the way we're going about it is absolutely politically driven, as far as
I'm
concerned.
So I didn't realize that OSHA separated from the CDC in 2019.
I feel that's what happened.
Like a plan, like pre-planned in a sense, because there was a little bit of talk about this disease coming from bats in China, and just like that, the CDC and OSHA splits, and boom, all of a sudden we have it here in the United States. And
you know, we had a very good effort on how to run that floor session. We were in control. I totally believe that the people on the right side of that were in control.
Good.
We knew who was going to speak. We knew who was going to vote. There were three people that we did not know exactly how they were going to vote. And the one person that morning, we knew how they were going to vote. So there were only two undecideds in the whole thing. There were a couple that were a little wishy-washy, so to speak, but we looked them in the eye. And the one thing I will say with our body that I work with, you look them in the eye and you say, where do you stand on that? And if they say, I got it, you know they're not going to flop on you. Or I don't support it. And there's no disrespect in that. If somebody gives you your word and you look them in the eye and then they come back and change that vote, that is not a good thing.
Sure.
So we knew there was no pressure on my end. I didn't stand up, although I have the information ready to go. There were some things that were spoken about that I could have stood up and talked about to go against, but we knew we had the numbers. So moving forward, the strategy was to amend it to get it to the conference committee. We would not have had the bill pass. We had 21 votes that would pass it unamended. So we had to, you have to amend it. Otherwise it would die.
So what did the amendment do?
So, like I told everybody, the amendment gets the bill to conference committee. As we were talking about amendments, they started growing. So there was four or five amendments. Senator Heitkamp voted on an amendment in the committee. He was the only one that supported that amendment. That's the amendment I believe we used, because it had some knowledge to it. The other ones, I don't think there was much effort put into them. So we went with that one. We had the person who Senator Bell, who brought forward the idea. We had her stand on the floor, very persuasive, did a great job explaining it, understanding where we were at with it. And that made a big difference.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah, Jan and I were actually there.
Oh, yes. Great. Yes. And so you were the rowdies getting gaveled down.
No, you're going to get us kicked out.
Right. And, we did some golf clapping, you know, like this. But I had never seen, you know, so much, not commotion, but so many people that were so passionate about it. It was nice to see.
You could feel in the room the fear. And you could feel in the room the unsettled attitudes and emotions of the Senate chamber.
Mm-hmm.
They were not comfortable that day. And that just speaks volumes of the groups that came forward, the citizens that came forward, and so respectful. And I know that the Lieutenant Governor let you guys go on after it passed.
Yeah, and
that
took
was
a
very
five-minute
respectful.
Break.
It was a kind of respectful on everybody.
It really
took
was.
A breath. I'm glad that when the thing passed, that nobody threw the masks out onto the floor. I had a thought that would be a punch it to you. It was so respectful. I just can't. The people that work on the side of liberty and freedom, they're not like our DAPL protesters,
right?
who we now have the old lady baby shakedown in the front door. You can't get in the your building,
because
our building. We're locked
DAPL
out of our
protest.
Building. That is so discouraging.
Right. So we only have about 15 seconds here, so we're going to pick up where we left off. But that's a whole other story, the DAPL protest, because there was never any. It was about the only Capitol that you could actually walk into without going through a barricade. But we'll be right back after these messages on Ladies of Another View on Back.
Jeez, what a mess. Look at that. There's roof stuff everywhere. It's so embarrassing. Ruins the neighborhood. Come on, humans. Let's get this fixed.
Don't let your roof go to the dogs. Call America's Best Contractors for your free estimate.
Need a new woof?
After checking with the rest, go with the best. America's Best Contractors. 258-2412. Online at americasbestcontractorsincorporated.com.
Indoor football is back in Bismarck. Bucks football season is right around the corner. Grab a friend or family member for a night of action-packed, hard-hitting entertainment. The Bucks open at the Bismarck Event Center May 8th as they take on the Massachusetts Pirates. Catch the sweetest seats in the house right on the sidelines with VIP service at a Bucks turf table. Available now for single game purchases. Secure your tickets today by calling 701-595-0771. Bucks football, half the field and double the fun.
At Beck Communications, we've been planning for your future. Over the past decade, we've placed nearly 200,000 miles of dedicated fiber optics in the ground. Enough fiber optic strands to circle the world 8 times. Taking no shortcuts, we connected every home and business in our service area with dedicated fiber optics. It's your personal, unrestricted, unthrottled connection to the world. Best of all, this dedicated fiber means you do not share your connection. We call this intimate, dedicated connection Beck Fiber.
Hello, I'm Mike Lindell, and as you know, my passion is to help each and every one of you get the best sleep of your life. That's why I created my new Giza Dreams bed sheets. The first night you sleep on my sheets, you'll never want to sleep on anything else.
Go to MyPillow.com or call the number on your screen right now to get your very own MyPillow Giza Dream sheets. When you buy one set of sheets, you'll get another set absolutely free.
For the best night's sleep in the whole wide world, visit MyPillow.com.
Ever been in a cave before?
It's our first time.
All right.
Where are you going?
I'll see you at the car!
But how will we?
The car! Your offer has been accepted. Ever bought a house before?
It's our first time.
All right.
Where are you going?
I'll see you at the closing.
But how will we?
The closing!
News brings you real people and real news. Every weekday on KNDB, KNDM, and KRDK. Start your evening with the Dr. Duke Show at 4. Take a fresh look at current events with Ladies of Another View at 4:30. Go down the road with Joel at 5:30. Watch No Apologies with Becker at 9. Cap off your night with No Filter with Debbie at 10. Beck News. Real people, real news.
Welcome back to Ladies of Another View on Beck. We were visiting with Oley Larsen from Minot, District 3. By the way, I was a Minot State Beaver.
Oh, there you go.
Yes.
Long story.
I know. It is a very long story. But anyway, we were talking about the bill yesterday, and you said it's about freedom, and it was about freedom. But tell us where it goes next. Is this a done deal?
Well, it's not really quite a done deal yet. What happens now is that it has been amended, so it has to go to conference committee. And then the conference committee will look at it. And if there's other amendments, they can further amend. Or if they don't like the amendment, they can take it off. It's really up to them. After it leaves them and whatever they do, it goes to each house. If the house further amended, it goes to them to vote on it. If they don't do anything and we decide to add an amendment, then we have to vote again if we want to further amend. And it will take that grinding, I guess you could call it. And then after that, then it will go to the governor for his signature. And then at that point, he has the option to move forward and sign it or veto the bill.
Well, if he vetoes it, is it just dead, or is there any chance for anybody to do anything with it?
So there's one last, that's where we go and reach for that AED thing or whatever that's on the walls to jumpstart it, right? So then it comes back to each house. The house, I believe the house where the bill originated from has the first vote. So they have the opportunity, 2/3 of the house, to turn it over to veto the vote. Then it comes to our chamber, and then we have the 2/3 as well. Our votes, when we had checked the numbers with our votes, we knew strongly that we had 24 votes, and that's why there was not a big pressure and a big fanfare on the Senate chamber, because we knew the bill was going to pass. So we're all holding we're keeping our powder dry, unless we have to come back and mess with it again. We need 2 votes to override the veto, and that's not hard. And I think my thought would be that the Republican majority will stick together and say, you're the executive branch, we're the legislative branch, we look out after our own. If those two of the group that did not do that, that could be problematic, or if somebody else changes. But I'm not sure with our information that anybody will change.
So where should a supporter's focus be at this point?
That's a great question. So continue to be in the Capitol. That is very effective, to just thank you for your vote. The people who didn't vote, I know it's hard to go up to them and say, thank you for your stance on that. I appreciate what you're doing. Would you, tell me why you didn't vote no? Don't put pressure on them. But then start focusing your area to the governor's office. Should be able to meet the governor. Not everybody. He's not as accessible as us. But if people keep saying, I'm here just to stop in and I want to have a chat with him or so, he may come out and he may talk to the citizens of North Dakota. Talk to one citizen. That citizen can look him in the eye. That means a lot still in North Dakota.
Yes.
Look him in the eye, have a conversation. If he's going to veto it, then we know. We did our part. The legislature did their part in this.
I think there's a money trail attached to all those mandates, too. So that's the bigger picture.
Yeah. Well, why do we always need this money? I'll say it again. We used to spend, they spend money like drunken sailors, and that is a disregard to a drunken sailor. We now spend money, I believe, like heroin addicts from Hollywood.
Wow.
It is unbelievable,
like
the amount
that.
Of money that goes through that building that we... That's another session.
Yeah, that's a whole other session. But we also had another great win yesterday with the NDSU kind of... They call it the Planned Parenthood bill, but it wasn't Planned Parenthood per se. It was funding for abortions from state universities.
And Senator Mardal, she is the expert on that. She's the one that brought it to our attention. This little battle with NDSU and their thumbing their nose at the legislator has been going on for years. They had been doing this. We sent out a letter saying, please don't do that. 50-some legislators signed it, went into the trash. He didn't care. This latest round, and there's been others, this latest round, Senator Mardal put that on there. Everybody can have the money they want. There's nothing keeping them from having the money. NDSU can have that money. They are not going to do Planned Parenthood. They are not going to be associated with them. And that individual at NDSU thinks that he runs the show. He does not think that that is a university that gets funding from the legislature. Mm-hmm. We pay the bills. He has totally lost track of that on this issue. I don't know about other issues. The Higher Education Board needs to do something, have an opinion, have a thought, saying, you know, this is bad for North Dakota, when somebody so arrogant will sit there and tell them, you don't tell me what to do.
Wow.
You also lead one of the most talked about groups on the Hill, a book club but it's for bills. Tell us what you do.
Well, we have had the Bastiat Caucus since I started session, and I was a young freshman looking for knowledge. I need to know what bills are in the House, what bills are in the Senate, what's happening. There's a total disconnect. Our Republican caucus is so huge that we can talk about one issue. And the issues might not pertain to anything that the caucus is doing, any of the legislative work concerning bills in our chambers. So there's a huge disconnect. Well, when like minds start coming together and people who don't know seeking knowledge come together to see what's happening, it starts to build a coalition. And so all of a sudden over in the House, all of these bills that are against the North Dakota platform, and that's what we are. We are Republicans that stand up for the North Dakota Republican Party platform. That's what we do. We have been branded, so now that we make a difference, we have been branded libertarians, and the governor took the reins and has been throwing us in the gutter, saying we're a bunch of guys from France. Or if he would come to our meeting and gain some knowledge, he would understand that Frederick Bastiat is the father of the Republican Party. So back overseas, when they had the big revolution and they were losing their mind, it wasn't working over there. We had our revolution over here with Thomas Jefferson. We all lost our mind. And what the heck happened? It started working. So he came over and he started thinking about and seeing the differences and talking about, why did this work? Why is it working? So that's what we are. We concentrate on policy, not politics. And we were a cocky little group, and we poked some people, and we're trying to be better. I admit my faults on that. I think our group does. We're just trying to get the word out, and we have been a force this session. The medical marijuana bill, Bastiat Caucus. Face mask, Bastiat Caucus. This abortion issue, Planned Parenthood, Bastiat Caucus. There are so many bills that are pushing to stick to those North Dakota Republican platform values. And it's...
We have less than a minute. Excuse me, less than a minute. I know Andrea is burning with a question there.
No.
Yeah, I want to know. You said if the governor would ever come, has he gotten an invitation?
It's open to everybody. And that has been a big change, too, because we used to be just legislators. And when I took over, everybody... that wants
so
our information.
So when and where? Quickly, we have about 30
Skyline
seconds.
Drive up at the motel up there.
Wingate.
On Skyline Drive, north of here.
Yeah, Wingate.
And
at the Wingate?
Every Monday, Wingate, yes. Every Monday, 7 p.m.
7 p.m. And how many members do you have? How many legislators?
Attendees.
We have a lot.
Okay. Top secret. Okay, well, there's so much more we would love to cover with you, but unfortunately we have run out of time. We just want to thank you for coming today.
Thanks
for
having me.
Thanks
for
all your hard work on the Hill.
Keep me on your prayer list. That's
we
all
will.
I ask.
Right up
you hear
there.
That? Keep them on your prayer list, you guys. Keep all your legislators there. Anyway, we'll be back right after this on Ladies of Another View on Back.
Today's households have more digital devices than ever before. More links to family, business, education, and entertainment. Beck Communications spent over 10 years building North Dakota's fastest fiber optic internet service, Beck Lightband Internet, outpacing speeds in large cities nationwide. Lightband Internet handles all your digital needs without throttling your connection to the world. Beck Communications, valuable digital connections in rural North Dakota.
Since opening in Hebron in 1940, Dakota Community Bank and Trust has been your hometown bank. Our mission has been to provide modern banking convenience with old-fashioned hometown service. We've grown with the communities we serve. Through year-round events, countless sponsorships, and nearly 7,000 hours of volunteering each year. Learn more about our 80-year history at dakotacommunitybank.com.
Respect, innovation, trust, and excellence. These core values can be seen in every building built by Straightway Construction. In the community for over 15 years, Straightway Construction has become the premier construction company for commercial projects. From dirt to design and framing to finish, Straightway Construction is your number one choice. You won't have to look far to find a project that has that Straightway touch. Call them today or go online to straightwayconstruction.com and let them make your vision a reality.
Jeez, what a mess. Look at that. There's roof stuff everywhere. It's so embarrassing. Ruins the neighborhood. Come on, humans. Let's get this fixed.
Don't let your roof go to the dogs. Call America's best contractors for your free estimate.
Need a new woof?
After checking with the rest, go with the best. America's Best Contractors. 258-2412. Online at americasbestcontractorsincorporated.com.
Hello, I'm Mike Lindell, and as you know, my passion is to help each and every one of you get the best sleep of your life. That's why I created my new Giza Dreams bed sheets. I started by using the world's best cotton called Giza. It's only grown in a region between the Sahara Desert, the Mediterranean Sea, and the Nile River. It's ultra soft and breathable, but extremely durable. My Giza sheets also include full 21-inch wide pillowcases that will fit over any pillow and deep pocket sheets that will fit over any mattress. The first night you sleep on my sheets, you'll never want to sleep on anything else.
Go to MyPillow.com or call the number on your screen right now to get your very own MyPillow Giza Dream Sheets. Giza Dream Sheets are available in a variety of colors. Use your promo code, and for a limited time, when you buy one set of sheets, you'll get another set absolutely free.
For the best night's sleep in the whole wide world, visit MyPillow.com.
Welcome back to Ladies of Another View on Beck. This brings us to our segment that we're going to talk about the Second Amendment and about President Biden's press conference today regarding the executive orders that he's anticipating on getting out. There's so much to cover. His speech, it took so long for him to go through it. It's like, come on, I just wanted to crack the whip. Can you talk a little faster? It's like, we'd never be able to invite him on the show because he doesn't talk fast enough.
Maybe we could just read the teleprompter ourselves.
Perhaps. quicker. And it's like, get it through. It took 35 minutes. But anyway, I just want to skip right to parts of it that I did pull out for our viewers.
And President Joe Biden has the will and the courage to act. As a United States Senator, Joe Biden took on the gun lobby not once, but twice, and he won. In 1993, he worked to pass the Brady Handgun Violation Prevention Act. This law established a background check system and has kept more than 3 million firearms out of the hands of dangerous people. A year later, he worked to pass another law to ban assault weapons and high-capacity magazines for 10 years. And as Vice President, Joe Biden led the Obama-Biden administration's efforts to reduce gun violence.
You know, we're joined today by the Attorney General, Merrick Garland, who I've asked to prioritize gun violence. Today, we're taking steps to confront not just the gun crisis, but what is actually a public health crisis. Nothing I'm about to recommend in any way impinges on the Second Amendment. They're phony arguments suggesting that these are Second Amendment rights at stake from what we're talking about. But no amendment to the Constitution is absolute. You can't yell fire in a crowded movie theater and call it freedom of speech. From the very beginning, you couldn't own any weapon you wanted to own. From the very beginning of the Second Amendment existed, certain people weren't allowed to have weapons. So the idea is just bizarre to suggest that some of the things we're recommending are contrary to the Constitution. Gun violence in this country is an epidemic. Let me say it again. Gun violence in this country is an epidemic, and it's an international embarrassment.
So did you guys catch?
Oh, sorry.
Oh, wake up, no. Jan. Jan, we're on. We're on, Jan. Oh. Sorry. Yeah. But anyway, did you see where he said he was going to prioritize gun violence? I think that was a slip.
Just a little bit.
But then he talked about eliminating 3 million firearms from the... The thing is criminals are going to be able to get guns no matter what.
Well, you cannot legislate criminals. I mean, come on, people. It's ridiculous. They're going to get it through the back channels that they've always gotten it through, and we are going to do it lawfully like we always have. Just like you can't legislate somebody drinking before they drive in the way that you would have to screen them to buy a car. Are you going to give somebody a mental health test to get their first Volvo? I mean, come on, it makes zero sense to me.
It makes no sense to me either. But really, the thing that strikes me is the things that he's attacking aren't really the problem, or they aren't major contributors to the thing that he's trying to solve. So if his priority is actually is gun control, then that's one thing. But if it's gun violence or danger from guns, then they're barking up the wrong tree, because it's not rifles that are the cause for the majority of these incidents. So the majority of gun violence isn't a rifle anyway, and that's the thing that they're coming after. So it doesn't add up. Their math is really quite terrible.
Well, and they're talking about the ghost guns, and that's where you can actually, you know, build guns and put parts on, and not each piece is registered, so then you have this gun. You can build it, and it's not registered anywhere because you made it on your own.
Well, they're making us want to do that. I mean, the more they push against the Second Amendment, the more they make us want to be resilient and inventive and do things ourselves, because Americans are like that.
Well, there's already a part that is usually serialized that you have to buy in order to construct any kind of a rifle. And it's not the trigger, actually.
No, it isn't.
That's a lot of people's first
misconception.
It's the lower, which is really more like a connecting piece that all the pieces connect to in order to build out your rifle.
And it almost seems like you may know a little bit about this.
I may have recently finished construction on my very first, yes, rifle.
That's amazing. Good for you.
Yeah. And I mean, you do have to, when you purchase that lower, you have to do the same registration that you do for any gun purchase. So if you're buying a lower that's ready to be built, as he's talking about when he says that you can construct a gun in 30 minutes with a kit, that's a lower that's finished or that's ready so that you can just assemble it. That's a piece you have to get registered. You have to go through your background check. You have to go through that full process that you do for purchasing any firearm. So that already exists. Now, all the other bits and pieces, some of them break. So what if you did have to have your trigger serialized and registered, and something were to happen with it and you need to replace what? What counts as a rifle? Is it the spring? Is it, like, what part? And then if you're going to have to replace those pieces, are you then going to have to re-register it as another new firearm? So say I go through a lower and two triggers, now I've built three rifles? No, that doesn't make any sense at all.
It's still just one.
Right. And the funny thing is, I shouldn't say funny thing, the serious thing is, a lot of this gun violence takes place in Democratic-led cities and communities. Yeah. And it's like, now wait a minute, why are you punishing? Because most of the lawful gun owners, a lot of them are on the right, or Republicans, you know. Mm-hmm. You know, they're on both sides. But the biggest place of gun violence are the cities led by Democratic governors, and it's just ridiculous.
Well, if you wanted to have somebody guess where the largest populations of lawbreakers are that use guns, you're going to hear Chicago, you're going to hear D.C., you're going to hear Los Angeles, that type of thing. You're not going to hear Mandan, you're not going to hear Grand Forks. Do accidents, murders, and violence take place in any of those places? Absolutely. We're not naive to think so, or think any differently. But these people that are trying to change things aren't looking at the real data, just like they haven't with this pandemic. That's where I'm at.
That's where she's at. We're just everywhere.
Yeah.
You know, it's just, go ahead.
So I would like to remember, because my brain's not helping me here, it's either January or March or Q1, but there's a state that had the most gun sales, registered gun sales, so these are legal gun sales, for it. And I would like to know which of the three. But it was a state that surprised me. Which one do you think?
Whoa.
I don't know. Pennsylvania.
Yep.
Wyoming.
Illinois.
Illinois.
What?
Wow. No, that's pretty much my reaction. Yeah. Illinois had the most legal gun sales? Okay. Mm-hmm. And so outside of Chicago, I suppose, where they have also the most gun violence, this is confusing.
Yeah.
What are they trying to do? I really want to know.
That's interesting.
So are they buying them all and then letting them get stolen so that they can...
It's
use
really
them in
surprising.
The city of Chicago? That's just crazy to
but
me.
But Chicago, which has all this really tight gun control and is where they're trying to protect people from guns, has the most gun violence.
Yeah. Right.
So it's not working. So now you're going to go and push that nationwide. Do you think it's going to work all of a sudden when you push it nationwide?
It can't work because criminals are always going to find a way to find guns. That's just the way it is. And if they can't find a gun, they're going to find another way to kill you. Just
yes.
Like over in England, they're having problems with stabbings because they don't own guns. And so to get murdered over there, they stab people.
And then in Switzerland, they all carry guns and there is no gun violence.
Oh, I wonder why that is.
Hmm.
Exactly. I think we should all go back to open carry.
Yeah.
I'm all for it.
But 100%.
You'd have to talk to those legislators and get them to change it here, too.
Well, it is open carry in North Dakota.
Constitutional carry, and I'd have to look. What do you have to do to open carry? I'd have to look.
Oh, all right, but we're not going to solve it all here right now because we got to take yet another break, and we'll be back after these messages on Ladies of Another View on BACK.
Respect, innovation, trust, and excellence. These core values can be seen in every building built by Straightway Construction. In the community for over 15 years, Straightway Construction has become the premier construction company for commercial projects. From dirt to design and framing to finish, Straightway Construction is your number one choice. You won't have to look far to find a project that has that Straightway touch. Call them today or go online to straightwayconstruction.com and let them make your vision a reality.
Deciding how to promote your business can be hard. Visit the professionals at Dakota Promotions and Printing and let them help you through your struggle. Dakota Promotions provides promotional items and apparel from corporate gifts to team shirts and everything in between. With quick turnaround times and friendly service, they are your best choice. And best yet, you're shopping local. Visit them online at dakotapromo.com or stop in their showroom at 320 West Main in Mandan. Dakota Promotions, delivering promotions just for you.
Every great pizza has a secret. At New York To Go, that secret lies in our perfectly recreated New York water, the key ingredient to making our signature New York-style pizza. We also feature gyros with the region's only gyro meat spit, plus Nathan's hot dogs, calzones, and our delicious jumbo buffalo wings. Try a 14-inch or our special giant 20-inch pizza tonight. You gotta know how to fold them if you wanna hold them. New York To Go, we deliver for you.
40 years ago, Aero Service Team started with one truck and lots of hard work.
Times may have changed, but the hard work that we put in to get your lives back in order after fire, water, and disaster hasn't.
Over the years, we've seen so many families lose their belongings due to water and fire damage. Restoring homes back to the original state has made every hour of hard work well worth it.
Thank you for trusting our family with yours.
When disaster strikes, you only have to make one call. Aero Service Team does it all.
Indoor football is back in Bismarck. Bucks football season is right around the corner. Grab a friend or family member for a night of action-packed, hard-hitting entertainment. The Bucks open at the Bismarck Event Center May 8th as they take on the Massachusetts Pirates. Catch the sweetest seats in the house right on the sidelines with VIP service at a Bucks turf table. Available now for single-game purchases. Secure your tickets today by calling 701-595-0771. Bucks football, half the field and double the fun.
I'm Rick Becker from No Apologies. Welcome to your After Hours Oasis of Sanity.
How can these people not see that they're just clowns?
We help simplify and educate you on things going on in the legislature and around the country.
Asking the hard-hitting questions.
But also having flea stack and Sid and Marty Krofft stuff, and we've talked about that sometimes. It's bad.
Watch us weeknights at 9 Central on Beck News and online at beck.news.
Welcome back to Ladies of Another View on Beck, where you get real news from real people.
Uh-huh.
I tell you what, there's been a lot of news going on around. You know, it's just been, it gets kind of overwhelming sometimes. And so we always like to end on a lighter note. And so that brings us to our lighter side. I think you're going to enjoy this. This is an a cappella group. They are sergeants across the United States. And they did this while they're all in their different cities. So take a listen to this. You patriots are going to love it.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today,
where the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away.
From the lakes of Minnesota
to the hills of Tennessee,
across the plains of Texas, oh, from sea to shining sea,
from Detroit down to Houston,
New York to LA,
where there's pride in every American heart,
and it's time we stand and say.
It's just so beautiful all these people did this from across the country and organized it. And it was courtesy of the U.S. Air Force Band.
Kudos. I'm sorry. Lee Greenwood, Home Free, you're my heroes, man. That's awesome. Okay.
What was that?
Stage makeup.
I was thought I was mic'd up. I wanted to sing along so badly.
I know. Thank you.
Oh, my goodness. They did a beautiful job.
Yeah.
Didn't they do a great job? I mean, it's just you get the chills when things like that happen. And I guess we just need to, you know, don't give up on America, you guys. It's like there we have so much to offer. We're going to have bumps, and we're going to have bumps for the next thousands of years. We are here to stay. We just have to protect our country. And that, you know, stuff like that gives me hope. Because
absolutely.
We always hear about those that are so unpatriotic right now, and it's just no pledge, no national anthem, no anything. But then when people like this get together and just show the American spirit, that's what America's all about.
They are a talented bunch for sure. And, you know, it just makes us realize if we would just take a breath, take two steps back, and take a look at what's happening, we are so blessed. There, I mean, we've always talked about blessings versus curses, and that can happen in any situation. But if we just start counting those blessings, just the little things, what are you thankful for? I mean, it's the list could be so long you wouldn't have time to complete it in a day if you look close enough.
You said bumps. I think we all have goosebumps.
Yeah.
Oh, isn't that big the time. Truth? It really does. I mean, I don't know. I've always been a patriotic person per se, but it's like when you see pieces like that, it just puts it up at another level. It's like a message from God that it's like we're going to be okay. We have some tough days to get ahead or to get past. But we're going to be okay. We're going to come out on the other end and be okay. So
we all have a purpose.
We
and
do.
We are all here at this time for the right reasons.
Right. And even, you know, with Oley coming by and he said how it's important for you to speak up and do it respectfully and do it that way.
Amen. I saw crocuses today.
Yay!
Amen. Nothing better than, you know, a nice spring day and ending on such a great note like that.
I'm going home to look for my daffodils and my tulips.
Perfect. Okay, well, thanks for joining us yet again on Ladies of Another View on Beck, where you do get real news from real people. And if you have anything to suggest, just let us know. We'll get it on. We'll see you next time on Ladies of Another View on Beck.